Gladhoppers. Justin was mentioning that sometimes we give the chickens a special treat. They always get chicken scratch and crumbles every day as part of their normal feed. However, every once in a while we'll have leftovers in the house that we like to process a little bit to give to them for a special extra tasty delight.
The chickens. Although whenever I hear that or say that, it makes me think of release the Kraken. There's that. There's the rock we move, and then shwala. Hey, little one. You want to be released too? Okay, come on. There you go. Release the kitten. you're funny. I forgot to mention, I was going to give him some treats, which is just this cranberry trail mix that got a little old, but chickens would love it, as you can tell. Almost all of them are over here trying to get Ed along with the cats. So I'll feed them for a little bit for today, and I'll give them some more later on this week and into next week.
Now they also get scraps from the kitchen when we put them on the compost pit, and we'll show you that here in a little bit. But there are some items that if we just throw it out in the compost pit as is, they may not be able to eat it very well. Or they might see it but say, nah, that's too much work, and they walk on. Because our chickens are picky that way. So, we use this handy-dandy blender that I got as a kid from my grandmother. And we found a purpose for it because we leave this one out here in the patio specifically to pulverize any foods that we're giving to the chickens or other animals. One example of the foods that we might use is something like peanuts that we haven't finished, but we've had them for a long time. So the taste isn't really the greatest anymore, but the chickens would still really love it. Now these are in-shell peanuts. They have not been shelled. So the chickens, if we just pour them in the compost pit, we'll probably be like, nah, and just walk on. But if we use the blender and chop them up, I'm sure they're going to say, "Ooh, what's this? Extra protein." I also mentioned the other day, whenever I was making the scrambled eggs, that we take the eggshells from our chickens' eggs, we rinse them with water, and then we let them dry. And so then, before we give it to the chickens, we also blend them and pulverize them. And we try to get them into very small pieces or even a powder, simply because if it's too big and possibly the chickens recognize it as an eggshell, they might start pecking at eggs after they lay them because they realize, oh, this could be a food source. But as long as you make it unrecognizable, majority of the time they're going to leave the intact eggs alone, so you'll still be able to collect the eggs that you want from your chickens. And we haven't really had much of an issue with the chickens cracking the eggs. I think most of the time when it occurs, it's because an egg has fallen from higher up. Like if the chickens lay it in one of the boxes higher up and it falls and it cracks, if the yolk or the egg white is exposed, then the chickens are going to go after it. But if it's an intact egg, for the most part, especially with the hens we have now, we don't have that issue of them being fed eggshell and then it being a problem with their eggs. Maybe we've just lucked out, but that's been our experience. So let's get going. Now, on the eggshells, well, really any food that I put in here, I try not to fill it too high because since we're trying to get it into a powder, a lot of times I'll be powder at the bottom and pieces on top, and I have to take it off and shake it, which usually I have to do anyway. But if I have too much in there, it makes it very difficult. Whereas if I do it in smaller amounts, the blender or food processor tends to be able to process it easier. And so it ends up being a little less work for me that way. Here we go. Now, I have done this in the house before. I prefer to do it out here in the patio because it does make a dust and there is a little bit of a smell whenever the eggshell is broken down into this fine powder. If you see, the inside of this blender, whatever you call it, is kind of a milky white color. That's because all those tiny, tiny powdery particles are in the air inside there. And if I pull the lid off now, those particles are going to go into the air. And I don't want to inhale that because I have done that before. It's not like horrible, but it's something I would rather avoid. So you can just let it sit, settle down until the air in there gets a little more clear. Most of the time, I don't really have the time to do it. So I just kind of hold my breath and then go so that I don't inhale it. But if you're inside, I would definitely recommend letting it settle for about maybe 2 to 5 minutes before you open it up and dump it and start your next batch. Okay, here we go. I hope the camera got that. That was kind of cool. Okay, let me bring it close so that y'all can see that powder. See how fine that particulate matter is? It's still cloudy. But it's a fairly fine powder. There are still some chunks in it, but it's not that bad. If you do have the problem with your chickens pecking holes into your intact eggs, then you may want to make sure that's ground even finer, either by putting it back in the blender or blending it longer, or even doing it manually with a mortar and pestle once you get it to this point. Because once you get it to this point, it wouldn't take a whole lot of work to do it by hand. That's probably good for that. And then this is a piece of our that was a piece of our tree collar. Figured that's probably got some vitamins and minerals in it that the chickens can benefit from. You may have to dig your finger in there to get the particulate matter out, or get a spoon or a knife or something, put it in there just so it doesn't stay trapped in the bottom in between your batches. Now for the peanuts. Now, obviously, I would say don't do this with your nice food processor unless you just really want to. I would say use an older one that you don't mind if it gets a little messed up, or go out and find one really cheap at a yard sale or an estate sale or at a thrift store, or maybe even find one on clearance at a retail store. That way you can keep it separate from what you actually use for your own food. But of course, it's up to you, and your frugality is however you choose to make it. One more batch of peanuts, and then we'll go out and look at that compost pit. And then I go ahead and put the lid on and shake it up so that they don't have all of one thing in any one spot. Sometimes I'll mix this in their feed as part of a treat, but today, since we're going to try to move the compost pit, we're actually going to put it down where the new compost pit is to start the chicken scratching in that area and get it off to a great start. Justin brought up a good point. We haven't fed them yet, so we'll go ahead and add a little bit of their feed to this and mix it up and then give it to them all at once.
So if everything goes to plan, on Christmas Eve, we'll have a video post in the morning and then one in the evening. Now, our internet isn't always the fastest or best, so if that doesn't happen, we may have one Christmas morning, but the plan is not to have one on Christmas so that you guys can enjoy your family and friends and just have a blessed Christmas. So wanted to let you guys know.
And we should have a video the day after Christmas, so we'll be back.
Yes. Merry Christmas and God bless.
Merry Christmas. Blooper reel!
So just want to let you guys know that if we do...
And then this is a piece of our... tree collar. That was the piece of our tree collar.
So if we...
Hoppers, thanks for watching the video. Push the thumbs up to like the video. Also hit that subscribe button, also the bell, so that you can get notifications when our videos come out.
Check us out on our social media pages too. We have Facebook and Pinterest, and soon we'll have Instagram. The links are below. Bye, y'all.
Good job.